nanoHUB-U, online instruction.
Hey everyone, welcome to lecture 3.19. So in the last lecture, we were just talking about how we can model different experimentally observed plasmonic light trapping structures for crystalline silicon photovoltaics. And so now we're actually going to explore more details of how we can fully understand and then optimize these sort of light trapping structures. And so this is kind of quantifying what is the enhancement of absorption associated with adding the silver nanoparticles, which we identified last time as the most promising type of structure for enhancing absorption. And you can see that with the nanoparticle, we can have absorption up to 65% at wavelengths that are very close to band edge because of this extraordinary field enhancement and confinement. Whereas if you did not have this sort of light trapping, then it's about almost an order of magnitude weaker absorption. So you go basically increase from 10% up to 65% with this sort of nanoparticle. And so then just zooming in again on the field enhancement, you can see that the field enhancement with the nanoparticle, it's like this. Without the nanoparticle, it's actually like orders of magnitude smaller. So this is like a really strong, significant effect. And so another way to look at it is kind of zoomed out from the previous picture, kind of looks like this. And so you can see that there's a big enhancement over the whole volume of the crystalline silicon, which might be like 2 microns thick. And then if you look at this as a function of texturing height, then you can see that actually with the plasmonic nanoparticle, especially for very short structures, that there's a marked improvement, but then the gap kind of closes as you increase the height to a large enough value. So that indicates that over the whole spectrum, it may not be extremely beneficial for a very thick structure. So say like a crystalline silicon wafer, but then for crystalline silicon thin film, where texture heights are limited to less than 1 micron, then this could actually be a big benefit or big boost. And so just to kind of visualize like what kind of outputs you get from these sort of systems, again, you have the parasitic loss quantified as basically subtracting 3.7 from the ultimate JSC that's possible. And then, of course, you have some reflection losses of about 5 milliamps per square centimeter, but you're still left actually with a surprisingly large value of 36.6 milliamps per square centimeter, which of course is below kind of the maximum theoretical value for silicon, but it actually comes not too far away from some of the world record wafer-based crystalline silicon cells. So that says, at least in principle, this sort of light trapping could allow you to reproduce the performance of a crystalline silicon wafer-based cell with much less silicon. This just showing like what the texture looks like for the system.